So I think a lot of us who have called fights in this apex over the last 5 weeks are trying to figure out what's going on. Is there something in the water? Is it the 25-foot cage? Is it the lack of a crowd? But Megan O'Leary, we have seen some of the best fights of the year, all in a very condensed amount of time. And just crazy, all the history that has unfolded inside this apex over the last 5 weeks.
Yeah, absolutely. This little building with no crowd has seen some incredible fights. And it's not just UFC fans and fighters who think that these fights have been just absolutely epic. It's fans around the world from all different walks of life. I mean, we saw names like LL Cool J and Mario Lopez, JD Martinez, Evander Holyfield, my guy Lil Wayne, all tweeting about tonight's fights. And rightfully so, with a main event like that. So it kind of got me thinking, 2020 has been a year for really epic fights. For me, the fight that still takes the cake is Zhang Weili versus Joanna Jędrzejczyk. That one earlier in March, that was my favorite fight of the year. We've got fights like Justin Gaethje versus Tony Ferguson that stick out. And then here at the Apex, I mean, for me, tonight's main event has got to be in the top three of fights for this year. Absolute incredible performance by both gentlemen. So I know there are a lot of opinions up there on the desk. John, who do you have in your top three for 2020?
Man, the producer Zach Candido wants to do this right now on live television. I'm trying not to have a recency bias, right? So I'm not going to put Poirier Hooker in my top three because I want to put some shine on some other fights. But certainly if you want to make an argument for Poirier Hooker, I'm okay with it. We had a fight with Vicente Luque and Nico Price a few weeks ago that has to be in my top three. I feel like last week when I was watching Josh Emmett and Shane Burgos, I was watching the fight of the year play out live, and then I get off the air and someone reminded me that Zhang Weili and Joanna Jędrzejczyk fought in 2020. So that's my top three right now. I'm sticking to it. We still got 6 months to go, though, this year.
I mean, I'm pretty similar to you, John. You got to go with Lee. You got to go with Jędrzejczyk. The way that they showed up and just scrapped, I mean, they set the bar for every woman on earth, in my opinion. Then you got Poirier versus Hooker. You can't do wrong with that. And Emmett versus Burgos. Both of these guys, what makes it all of them the top fight was, most of the time when you see that much damage, it's just standing there trading. They're using technique and trading. They're slipping punches. They're throwing different combinations. It's not just a war standing and trading. It's technique with war, and it's amazing to watch.
Guys, they clearly said your top three, okay? I'm hearing a lot of ums and ahs, a lot of sitting on the fence. I'm going to do it in style. In reverse order, here's what we've got. Okay, I've forgotten.
Yeah, there you go.
After all that, Gaethje versus Ferguson, no. The producer shouldn't have that on there. But Burgos versus Emmett, that was last week. That was incredible from start to finish. Number two, I've got Zhang Weili versus Joanna Jędrzejczyk. Come on, that fight was just incredible from start to finish. But that right there, what we just saw, for me, and as you said, recency bias, that is a thing. Maybe it's part of the reason, but I'd be lying if I didn't say in my mind right now, that's one of the best fights I've ever seen.
It feels to me like Zhang Weili and Joanna Jędrzejczyk is going to be hard to dethrone. I just think the fans are so behind that for fight of the year, but hey.